Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're going to be continuing with, I guess, part three of my to-do list. If you missed the first two sections of this particular to-do list, the first focusing in the garden and the second focusing downstairs, go check them out. I'll link them in the cards as well. In today's video, I'll be finishing off the last two items on the downstairs to-do list before heading upstairs, starting with cleaning the inside of the fridge. As you can see, I'm pointing out where there's a fair few spills from jars and other containers. This was filmed the day after a grocery delivery, so the crisper and the dairy snack drawers have already been cleaned out and put in the first in, first out order, as in the closest expiry dates are at the front and the longest lasting dates are at the back to help avoid food wastage, essentially. So this isn't going to be a full fridge clean out where I empty out the entire fridge contents for a thorough clean. Today is more focused on cleaning up the spills that have occurred on the shelves and doors, and then transferring some of the groceries into food storage containers and a general tidy, which will be done just shelf by shelf. So I know turntables are a huge trend at the moment, or back on trend, and as you see, I'm absolutely no stranger to them. Does anyone else use them though in their fridges, like multiples of them? I know they're big in pantries, and if I had corners in my pantry, I would 100% use them. But as you can see, I've got two in there, one for our open jars and one for our sandwich and bread condiments, like toast condiments, I guess you would call it. But yeah, just a quick query. How many people are turntable lovers? How many people hate them? And who thinks they're actually useful in the fridge? I know I do, but just wanting to throw that out there. Also, just throwing out there that the container of kimchi I just held out for you. Just sharing that one because it is for a packaged kimchi. Absolutely delicious. So if anyone out there is a kimchi fan and can get their hands on this brand, give it a try. All right, so moving on to the downstairs windows, I'm giving them a clean with my co-surface spray and the window cloth, the glass cleaning cloth that comes with the kit. These back windows don't get cleaned very often, so it's a bit hard to see in the footage, but they were absolutely filthy. There's a couple angles later where you can see it better. I don't clean them too often, only because as soon as they're clean, family members, including the dog, will walk into the glass thinking that it's open. I know you can get those stickers that you put on to show when glass doors are open or shut, but they just, aesthetically, I just do not like them, so I haven't put them up. And instead, there's a good shot of the grubs. But instead, we kind of just let all the dog snot and children fingerprints do that for us until we have an event on or people coming over, or I just get so frustrated with it that I need to give it a good clean. Excuse my terrible dance moves there. Tim was playing a new song he discovered for me, so we kind of got a little bit of a dance on outside during the session, because, you know, it's always fun to do that. So because as I was saying, everyone walks into the glass after it's been cleaned, and because Tim had taken Tim and Tom, out for a walk, I finish off the cleaning of the back doors. Also, it's a really nice day, by opening up the glass doors all the way and shutting the fly screen just to make sure no one accidentally walks into the glass. The fly screen really helps show that that door is shut. And then moving into the front room, I'm using the same spray, just a new cloth. And then when I go to the outside area, I use the hose. And I actually used dishwashing liquid on the front windows with a non-scratch scourer. It works so well to get all the dirt, grime, and if there's any grease from I don't want to know what on any of the surfaces, that all comes off as well. So moving into the next day, I think this might have been a day or two later. I'm moving upstairs to get the rest of the upstairs stuff done. And as you can see, my daughter's room is just a bit of a disaster today, and the dust build up on her shelves it's real life. This happens. So I'll start off in her room with giving it a tidy, a dust. I always work from the top down, or try to work from the top down. And then I'm going to also be bringing up the carpet cleaner today to get all of the upstairs carpet cleaned, because they are well and truly due. And in Neve's room specifically, you can see there probably that there is a dark brown patch on the carpet from mud that got tracked in, so that definitely needs to get cleaned out. So if you live outside of Australia, I'm not sure whether or not you have experienced the Ushi craze that occurred here, all these little rubber Disney characters that you can put on the end of pencils, that kind of thing. When they came out, Neve decided she wanted to collect some of them, which is, you know, great, I'm all for collecting. But when it came to dusting just then, I struggled a bit because she is so cute and she set them up in a very specific order that she likes. So I have to move them in a way that I will remember exactly which order they are when I put them back for her. And as I said, now I'm moving into doing the carpet, giving it a good vacuum on deep vacuum, and then bringing in the carpet cleaner. I also don't know what's happening with the lighting and the camera in the upstairs footage, because it makes the carpet look, I don't know, extra grubby and almost like a yellowish brown, but in reality it's actually a light beige color. There's a close-up shot later that momentarily I think you'll see where it actually shows the true color of the carpet. Yeah, there you go. So it's more of like a beigey white than a yellow brown. Those two stains that I mentioned before, I'm just going to start those off with a quick pre-treatment from the direct shot on the Bissell Pro Cleaner, and then I'll get into carpet cleaning the rest of the carpet, and we'll continue that throughout the whole of the upstairs area as well. So as I said, I like to try and clean from the top down, and this is a perfect example of why. So this is the air conditioning filter, where it catches all the dust and other bits and pieces in the air going back up into the filtration system. It normally doesn't look quite as bad as this, but I missed the last clean. So it's meant to be cleaned out every season change, and I haven't done it for the last season, maybe even two. So it might be 6 months to 9 months overdue. So I'm going to get started with that, and I'll show you a close-up as well of the actual filter inside. This is me trying to figure out why it's not coming open. It's a bit stuck. But I'll show you how grubby it is and how satisfying it is when it gets cleaned. This is the bit I find really satisfying, when you get the dust off and it leaves those sort of dust-free lines. It's amazing. So there's two ways to clean this filter out. One is to give it a very gentle vacuum with a soft attachment, and the other is to take it out and run it through the hose, and then you can put it back up once it's mostly dried off. Then while standing up high, I'm just going to give that ceiling light a wipe down as well, because whilst I was up there, I noticed that had also developed a bit of a build up. And then again, as I said, working my way down, I'll be dusting off the areas in that section before tackling the carpets. Alright guys, I hope you found today's video motivational and inspiring. If you're new, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate the support. And if you are returning, thank you so much for coming back again. I really enjoy and appreciate your support. We'll just be finishing off today in the master bedroom. I didn't capture everything on camera simply because there's a few things underway in the master bedroom at the moment, which, you know, stay tuned for a future video featuring that. but essentially I just gave all the surfaces a big dust. I do forget to do our master bedroom as often as the other rooms, simply because no one goes in there except for my husband and I. But every time I do the dusting of the ceiling fan and some of the other surfaces, it really horrifies me that I'm sleeping in a room with this in the air. So got that one tackled, and then signed off. So thanks again for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Have an amazing week, and I'll see you next week for the next video. Bye, guys.